Well, good afternoon to everybody, and I just want to let you know that I am ridiculously proud to be able to stand here with Chief Daryl Forte, the officers and staff of the Kansas City, Missouri Police Department, the ATF, FBI, Prosecutor's Office, Grandview Police Department, Lee Summit, Leawood Police Department, and Missouri Highway Patrol, as we celebrate the only good that comes out of such violence, and that is the apprehension of the potential perpetrator of that violence. Other than that, you know, the other thing that we should be considering is the fact that our citizens now should have a heightened sense of security and safety on our highway. The men and women who have worked this case have worked around the clock in recent weeks. They are people who live and work in this community, and they have been working to make sure that the other people who live and work in this community can travel the roads of the community safely and with some peace of mind. Chief, on behalf of the city, I definitely want to thank you and your staff and the KCPD for all the work that you did. To all the partners who were engaged, I want to thank you for all the work that you did, the resources that you brought, the commitment you showed. Even though you don't necessarily all live in Kansas City, Missouri, or where these acts were perpetrated, this is an example of a community that comes together. But even more importantly, this is an example of what happens when law enforcement comes together. Now, we have an ongoing and continuous relationship with each and one of these officers and their departments in this city. This is what happens when we have that collaborative effort of federal and state and multi-cities and other departments. Anything that comes in to jeopardize these relationships that we currently have, I assure you, will have a detrimental impact and effect on the city, and that's something that we have to always guard against. So day in and day out, these people are putting their lives on the line for us. And the only difference is that most days, they aren't being monitored 24/7 by media outlets from all over the country. But since everybody is here today, I want to make sure that I'm blunt in saying that our law enforcement partnership with these agencies and the work that they do is absolutely essential to reducing the violence in this city and controlling those issues like this so that there is some sort of ability for us to apprehend the people who perpetrate the violence. I'm very proud that they got this job done, despite the fact that it was a difficult job to do. So I'd like to thank them, and I'd like to make sure that we all thank them for everything that they did. Thank you very much. You know, our community members deserve a tremendous amount of praise in this as well. But for the tips that were received by the public, the apprehension may not have happened. The public engaged in this. They called when they saw something suspicious. They offered information if they had it. And they remembered, they understood that it takes teamwork to get something like this resolved. Law enforcement alone cannot make our neighborhoods safe. They need the help of people who live and work in the city and in those neighborhoods. So to the folks of Kansas City, first of all, and all over the region, thank you for engaging and calling and providing tips. And I want to remind us once again, if you see crime, report it. If you know somebody who committed a crime, report them. If you're suspicious of someone or some activity, let the appropriate authorities know about your suspicions. This case is a prime example of the positive results that come from a community joining forces against crime. This is a high-profile case because of its very nature, but there are other cases out there that simply because they're not as high-profile don't garner these types of headlines and attention. But rest assured that this urban area, along with other urban areas in this country, are experiencing slow-motion mass murder every single day. Every single day. And that is why we need the citizens of this city to stand up, and when they see something that is dangerous or violent or criminal, that they let the authorities know so that we can try to put an end to it. We need the community to help our law enforcement partners so that we can have a seamless approach to crime. So I'm asking everybody who sees crime or sees something suspicious to let somebody know, because it's only through doing that that we are going to stop those individuals who terrorize our neighborhoods, streets, and our cities. Today can be the beginning of a new chapter. We can write our own future if we can get everybody on the same page to understand that it is time for us to stand up and say that we are tired of violence, we are tired of crime, and that we are going to take steps, bold steps, brave steps, to stop it. And it does take a little bravery, but at the end of the day, it's better than living in fear. And I want to again thank our law enforcement partners and everybody involved in this for allowing the citizens of this city to feel a little safer today, a little less fearful today, and for giving them a very visible, open reminder of what happens when we work together. And this is the result. Thank you all very much.